Before the dawn of time, before the creation of things seen and unseen, the Lord God was. The Lord God consisted of three in one, known as the Godhead. He fashioned his throne upon the sea of glass, brilliant beyond imagining. He fashioned a chariot of wheels within wheels, of enormous and dreadful size, to which his throne sat upon. With the kingdoms of heaven completed, the Lord God prepared himself to speak into being its inhabitants. God said, "Let us create the heavenly beings as spirits, just as we are. They shall be called our servants, and they shall be called the angels." He created the angelic host, numerous as the sands of the sea, and as immeasurable as the stars in the heaven. He created the high-ranking seraphim, cherubim, and ophanim first. God created the six-winged seraphim, who are fiery, powerful beings reserved as the cleansing agents of God. He created 16-winged and higher-ranking 24-winged cherubim. The 24-winged cherubs shield themselves with their additional wings while in the presence of the Most High, for if they did not, they would be consumed like flaming fire. They stand on the sea of glass below the throne and fly in the great hall singing and shouting praises. Amongst these angels, the Lord appointed four to be paired with each wheeled ophanim that supported the throne. Their appearance is like burning coals in a fire, and their bodies crackle with thunderous sound. He set them in rank, file, and order. The ministering angels were placed under the ophanim. Over the ophanim, he appointed the 16-winged cherubim. Over these 16-winged cherubim, he appointed the seraphim. And over the seraphim, he appointed the 24-winged cherubs. The Lord God then appointed the archangels. Michael, Gabriel, Raphael, Uriel, Raguel, Serachiel, and Remiel. These are they who would come to be counted amongst the sons of light. Michael, Raphael, Gabriel, and Uriel would later become known as the four beasts who stand in the presence. He also created Samyaza, Arachibel, Remiel, Kokabil, Tamiel, Ramiel, Danel, Ezekiel, Barachiel, Azazel, Amarasol, Batariel, Ananiel, Zachiel, Samsapiel, Satiril, Terrell, Jamjael, and Seriel. These are they who would soon become counted amongst the sons of darkness, those that would soon fall from grace following the first in rank in rebellion. The Lord had created all of the angels except for one whom would surpass all the other angels in brilliance, splendor, and authority. This angel would be appointed over a third of the angelic host and would lead in praise and worship of the Godhead. He would stand closest to the throne in authority, clothed in shimmering color and wings like no other. This cherub was exquisite in beauty, and his name would be called Lucifer, the son of the bright morning star. God's heavenly creations were complete. Lucifer and all the sons of God worshipped and shouted for joy upon the sea of glass and glistening throne of God. God spoke, calling forth his crown cherub and chief archangels. "Lucifer, thy bright and morning star, it is you who have been elected over a third of the stars of heaven as your brethren. Be not wise in your own wisdom, Lucifer, and be not taken over by your exceeding beauty, for you are my creation, created under my authority. Come and take your position at my left-hand side of power." Lucifer was appointed chief of praise, while the four of the presence were appointed as guardians of the four corners of the throne. Lucifer deliberated the position of Michael over his own, but quelled these thoughts beneath the exquisite beauty and brilliance of himself. Lucifer fervently led the worship of praising of the Most High in choral magnificence. The myriad of angelic voices rejoiced before the sea of glass and throne of glory. 24-winged cherubim and 6-winged seraphim positioned around the throne, chanting, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord Almighty. Heaven is full of thy glory." 16-winged cherubim flew about praising and glorifying around the throne of God. The head of days thought it time to create for himself his most magnificent creation. He would create an expanse of space, time, and dimension for which this new creation would dwell. In this finite world, he filled it with the first spark of light, then stars, planets, and one with rich vegetation and sentient life. The angels stood in awesome wonder as God breathed life into his new creation, which was unlike any other creature he created before. It was made in the likeness of God, a spirit being clothed with flesh. The four of the presence positioned on high watched along with all the heavenly host. God instructed Lucifer and a third under his command to depart to earth, who would send Michael with further instructions at a later time. However, Lucifer was unsure and uneasy about this new creation. Seeds of contempt began to enter him. the angels in the heavenly realm rejoice with great exhilaration at the new creation of man. In heaven, unbeknownst to Lucifer, God had declared that the angels would serve this new crowned creation. The angels bowed in acknowledgement of God's declaration and that they would serve mankind and watch over them. Amidst the celebrations in heaven, Michael was sent to deliver this message to Lucifer. Upon arrival, Michael greeted his brethren Lucifer and decreed what the Lord God had commanded. Lucifer raged with anger as he saw it unfitting that the most magnificent angel of heaven would have to serve a creature that was created lower than himself. Michael rebuked Lucifer for his poor judgment against the commandment of the Lord, but Lucifer lashed back. "If it displeases him, then I will ascend to heaven and set my throne above God's, and I will sit upon the Mount of Congregation in the sides of the north." Michael, shocked by his brother's reasoning, departed back to heaven. Michael reported all that had taken place before the throne of God as Lucifer and those under him made their arrival. Lucifer entered the throne room of God as the angelic hosts muttered amongst themselves. The head of days spoke, "Lucifer, thou wicked and unappreciative cherub, what is this that thou hast refused to obey my command?" Lucifer responded, "I am Lucifer, the bright and morning star. It is beneath me to serve that inferior being that you call man. I will not obey your decree, nor will my angels with me." The Lord replied, "Lucifer, you have taken a great task upon yourself. You have elected yourself to be just as I am, and you have vowed to ascend above my throne in heaven. Make genuine your foolish threats by taking down your shielded wings, and let us speak face to face." Humiliated and powerless, Lucifer responded, "If it is man who you want me to serve, then I would rather serve myself." The Lord's judgment came firmly. "Lucifer, thou wicked and ungrateful cherub, you were once holy, but now you are stripped of your holiness. You have made a gross error in your freedom, and have vowed to ascend above your creator. For this I will cast you from my presence, granting you a segment of time to reign and put a rest to the challenge of my authority. Thereupon, you will be cast into the lake of fire for all eternity." God commanded Michael and the heavenly hosts to expel Lucifer and his rebel angels who wished to follow him. There was war in heaven as the faithful angels of light fought their fallen brethren. The faithful angels seized them, cast them out, and placed guards at the mouth of the portals of heaven. The fallen sons of darkness were banished from returning, except for their leader, Lucifer. Lucifer and his rebel angels defeated, wandered space of the finite world. Lucifer, embittered, said, "We are not conquered. This is but our beginning. I am Lucifer, the bright and morning star." The fallen rebels embark to Earth, and Lucifer succeeds in deceiving Adam and Eve to eat the forbidden fruit in the Garden of Eden. With the fall of man, Lucifer is permitted into the courts of heaven and confronts God, demanding justice over the fallen human race, now tainted by sin. Is handed down, his crowned creation is to suffer the same fate as the sons of darkness, eternal separation and punishment in hell. Originally created for the fallen angels, the human race would now suffer the same fate. Lucifer's band of rebels descend to earth and scheme to corrupt the race of men by taking upon themselves wives. They birth an evil race of hybrids called the Nephilim. Their plan is to corrupt the bloodline of men, but all but a preserved line of God's people endure. God promises to send one whom will conquer the seed of the serpent. He is revealed to the angelic host of heaven through the mystery of the Godhead, the Father, Spirit, and Son. This elect one is he who hath righteousness and was named before time began. Before the sun and signs were created, before the angels of heaven were made, he was. He shall be a staff to the righteous, whereon to stay themselves and not fall. And he shall be the light, the Gentiles, and the hope of those who are troubled of heart. All who dwell on earth shall fall down and worship before him, and will praise and bless and celebrate with song the Lord of the Spirits. For this reason he has been chosen and hidden before him, before the creation of the world and forevermore. The wisdom of the Lord of Spirits has revealed him to the holy and righteous, for he has preserved the lot of the righteous, because they have hated and despised this world of unrighteousness, and have hated all its works and ways in the name of the Lord of Spirits, for in his name they are saved.